technically, no, one second. It is no argument. Which company in the world takes taxpayers' money and puts it into a fund by which past and present Air India chairman and managing directors and their families can fly executive class around the world for the rest of their lives? Which company in the world uses taxpayer money to extend the benefits of free travel? Yes, benefits of free travel. It's ridiculous.
I'm sorry. I'm 100% confident this cannot be part of the service rules.
No, this is a created rule.
Give me a half a minute on it. Air India's job is not a pensionable job like the government of India.
Oh, so this is part of the pension.
The only retirement benefit that the employees of Air India get is medical coverage.
This is ridiculous.
Shipping companies have shipping benefets. Railways have railway benefits. If it calls for a review, let it be reviewed.
Why the Modi government says that we don't want, you know, this kind of expenditure. I think it is a very important opportunity for the Modi government to send a message. Make an airline efficient.
I agree with you.
Make an airline. Take away these rules.
I agree with you.
Let's get R.K. Singh in.
Come out very clear. The present government should come out very clear that they want to now change and reform in terms of efficient.
If the Babus allow them.
Public sector organizations.
Yes, R.K. Singh.
In the interest of the passengers and citizens.
R.K. Singh.
Arnab, you see, there are two things. Number one, you can't compare officers who come on deputation for 3 years or 5 years with officers who have worked for 30 years. So, while you can say that, okay, officers who have worked for, or staff who have worked for 30 years, can be given privileges, the same does not apply to officers who go on deputation for the government for 3 years or 5 years or 7 years. So that is why the government circular said that this benefit will not be extended to officers who go on deputation to Air India. So extending that to those officers was wrong, first thing, because they only served 3 years or 5 years and then they joined for life.
I think the culture has to change.
In Air India.
I disagree. My problem here is that I find today that
officers who have worked for 30 years, they can be given a benefit only if the Air India can afford it. If the Air India is in huge losses, how can you give a benefit like this?
Either way, in both cases,
it is not justified.
No, sir, you know, since we have been doing these reports yesterday, some interested partitas are saying to us, why do you want to take away these rights from us? Similarly, I can ask a counter question. Do we gain something if we ensure that our railway minister in the future can't pay 20,000 rupees? Is that the intention of Times Now? That in the future, tomorrow, somebody does not get bakshish? Well, if a railway minister wants to give bakshish, give it from your own pocket. Just because it has been happening, because it has been happening does not make it right. Dowry was happening for several hundred years as some kind of a convention. You know, this whole system of entitlement, it's a bottomless pit. But it's the kind of bottomless pit which politicians have encouraged, you must know this. And they're out of sync. Yes.
Arnab, you must know this. I want to tell your viewers that any consumer or any passenger who gives a feedback in Air India or on the railways, they never get a feedback. They never get action taken report. There is no serial number given in that feedback form.
Yeah.
You can't even trace and track what the passengers have written.
And you know, this man, Mr. Reddy, this Minister of State, actually, I think Mr. Reddy and Mr. Mallikarjun Kharge should be coming out and apologizing because they have been completely... They should be made to pay back.
If you commit a crime...
Absolutely, nothing less than that. I can see no reason why
they should not be sent to prison, at all to set us... whole thing of forgiving and maafi mangi...
I would just like to step in here. Without wanting to defend any individual, let me tell you, this has come to light now, and that's why we are talking about this.
Did the minister not know? If you want me to make a point, allow me to complete it.
There's no point in you interjecting without allowing me to complete what I want to say. So just hang on for half a second and you'll get your answer. This has been happening for ages. It's come to light now. It's wrong. It cannot be supported. It has been happening for lots and lots and lots of years now. Successive governments have been doing this time and again. But that does not justify anything.
This has to be stopped.
Pulling out one or two names and talking about one or two ministers is not going to solve the problem. The problem lies.
You know what the problem is. I'll tell you what the problem is, and I'll take. You know what?
You are trying to politicize an issue which does not deserve to be politicized.
I am not.
This has been happening across party lines. Across governments.
Are you at a political rally?
Arnab Goswami.
Are you at a political rally?
If you really want to you make this debate fruitful,
are you on an election
If you want your viewers to benefit from this, let's solve the problem.
Not just give a flavor to this debate and try to create a scene out here.
That's not going to help your viewers.
You know, Rahul, I'll tell you one.
So, I'm just trying to tell you, address the question at hand.
The problem with politicians and bureaucrats, just pardon me one second, and don't interrupt me right now. Is that the moment you feel that the culture in our country is changing, and what is the perk anymore of being a politician?
Who on this panel has said what's happening is right? Other than you. I mean, you're the only one who's blaming everyone and saying that all of us in one breath have said that we don't support this, what's happening is wrong.
But Arnab, the problem is you want to give a color and flavor to your debates.
You never want to hear what's right.
Rahul,
what I've said
is the election over. Are you on election?
What I have said is what's been happening.
I want to say something.
What's been happening with the railways or with Air India cannot be justified. That has to be stopped. And by blaming one minister or two ministers is not going to solve the problem.
Regardless, this has been happening across party lines. Now can you just stop here? You know, I'll tell you. I just want to talk to the viewer for 1 minute. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're watching this debate here right now, I get a sense that the politician on my right and the ex-bureaucrat on my left are threatened tonight. That the Absolutely. Now you made your observations, let me make mine.
I take serious objection to what you said. I am sorry, Mr. Arnab Goswami, right at the beginning of your debate, I said I don't support this. And I definitely will not support such.
Then why are you defending?
Why are you so much on the defensive, Mr. Bhargav? Mr. Bhargav, give me a minute, please. I'm requesting you. You give me a minute now, please.
I'll
tell you one thing. You know, please do not do this. Just let hear others also. I know it is sometimes difficult, but I'll tell you what upsets people in this. What upsets people is. The culture in our country is like this, that a mantri says, you know, my staff has worked very well for me and they have done a great job and I think we are going to give them cash awards. 121 people have been killed in rail accidents since June 2013. Now, if that selfish mantri thinks that it's a great job and if he then says, if you then ask them, people like Mr. Rahul Narvekar will say, you know, it's been happening. It's now been found. We'll have to correct the system and then give some kind of a lecture on it.
What hurts genuinely is that all this while, because I didn't want to politicize the debate, I didn't give you examples during the NDA regime what had happened in the rail. I'll give you examples. Let's make it a political thing. But Mr. Goswami wants to politicize it.
You have been in the government for a short while.
I'm just be silent now. I'm taking a caller. And our first caller, is Dr. Pradyuman, because I really want to hear from the people today from Mysore. Dr. Pradyuman, good evening.
Good evening, Arnab.
Good evening, sir.
I have 2 points. One first to the previous Shiv Sena and present NCP Rahul Narvekar.
Yeah.
Nobody is politicizing this issue. Please, Narvekar, note this point. Another to the Air India administrator, ex-administrator. Now, I also worked in a government hospital and government service. It was a non-pensionable job and recently I resigned and working independently. And I'm paying around tax of around rupees 3 lakhs per year and not getting any freebies. See, if my tax is going for freebies for others, then why should I pay my tax? then I will try to avoid my tax, and by this
well
government,
said.
I mean the whole India will well get said. Into the actually well get well into said. The problem.
Well said. Well, Mr. Pradyuman, I think that's a very straight observation. I think it puts it in perspective. Our next caller. Just keep hearing our viewers tonight. All you need to do, Mr. Bhargav, is you need to hear the viewers and then you will understand the way people think, not a bureaucrat thing. Sandeep from Mumbai. Sandeep, go ahead.
Arnab, hi. First of all, Sandeep. I just want to say one thing for you. What we actually feel is, I just have one word for you, which is respect. Okay? So no one can ever tell you that you've colored things or whatever it is. Moving on to my points. You know, culture, as you spoke of, well, it's when you talk to their kids, especially these the big daddies, we have three things. You know, you calculate things, 70,000 per ticket, business class, into 100 tickets. What's the total? Why don't you invest that in your services? Air India, I will travel, I have traveled twice and I never traveled again with Air India. You should invest in your services. Why do you think you are in losses? This is the reason. You should talk to your staff about it. You should see what the infra like, okay? Why can't you give that money to the defense guys, the people who have given their life for their country? You know, you want to give 15,000 rupees to someone, give 5,000 to one family that is travel at least once anywhere in India, 2,000 rupees at the IT cost.
Absolutely.
Why
absolutely.
Can't we do that?
Sandeep, no, there's no, you know, this is not, this is just the voice of the people. There is no, there is nothing to say. Yes, Dr. Datta, you see, the fact is, my government, my system, I will make the rules that suit me. You know, this just must change. The new India hates this, Mr. Datta.
Yes.
And don't tell me about Air India employees. I have traveled on Air India flights where hard-working cabin crew come up and tell me that we can't say anything. We are silenced. We don't get our salaries on time. It sometimes come months
exactly.
late.
Exactly.
You know, and they have told me, we feel sorry sometimes for the breakfast we have to serve because even our vendors are not paid on time. You see, so it's not because there is no money. It's because that entire system works to oil a few people who think that this is one fat elephant and I'm going to get a free ride on it while I'm there and while I'm out of it. One more caller, please. One more caller. Okay, we'll take a caller. We'll take a caller after some time. I hope you're getting the sense of what I'm saying. Yes, Mr. Datta, I hope you understand where I'm coming from. I'm not laying the blame, sir.
Yeah, and I do understand what you're saying. No, please, one second. You see, these agreements with the old employees of Air India is a bilateral agreement. It is not a freebie which is given for a person who's come for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years or so on. We are regular employees of Air India. Like the services get pension, we don't get pension. They give us still a few perks here and there. That's why I say it is morally incorrect to compare us with the people who have come on deputation for 2 years.
No, that's it. No, I am on the issue of principles.
To add to what Dr. Datta has said, these tickets are subject to load. Only if there is a vacant seat on a flight does a employee get accommodated. It is not. And you will have many instances at Mumbai Airport and other airports of employees going to the airport, all with the bags, etc., and then returning home because they couldn't get a seat on a flight. So what you need to do is to work out the costing. How much is it costing? And then talk about it, as I've raised it yesterday also.
Costing?
The bigger issue is, why is Air India in a critical mess?
No, who's responsible for it?
Unless you answer that query, why are you trying to tax the employees?
Don't broad base this. And
you are making the subject for discussion. Why are you doing it? Because of the weak financial state of Air India. So unless you address that issue, how can you be talking about
Well, you know, I think we are getting a lot of feedback on this particular subject. The point has been made. I am just making a genuine request to the new civil aviation minister and the new railway minister, Mr. Sadanand Gowda and Mr. Raju. Don't pretend, Mr. Raju and Mr. Gowda, that this issue will go away. If you think this issue will go away, if you think it's a one-day story and then we will move on, you've got it all wrong. If you don't act today, then your government is no different from previous governments. You wanted to make a change. Here is your opportunity. If you want to be like other politicians were, then don't say that things change and acche din aage. I'm going to take a break at this point. Mr. R.K. Singh, you can take this issue to those in the government who matter because you are in the BJP. Thank you very much for joining me on that debate. Thank you.
We'll do that. Thank you.